Hi friends, welcome back to SPK English Academy. I hope you have watched my previous videos. They will definitely help you to prepare well for the examination of KSAT and NET. Already in Karnataka state, KSAT announcement or the notification is made. The examination will be held in the month of April. There is no more time for preparation. Watch my videos and prepare well. I hope all of you get eligibility for this examination. Friends, in today's class, I am going to discuss one of the most important poets of English literature and critics and poet of that Elizabethan age. Philip Sidney, who lived from 1554 to 1586. The 16th century saw the need for a proper understanding of the nature and function of poetry was widely felt. There are many reasons for this. Much confusion prevailed regarding the true nature of poetry. The courtiers of Queen Elizabeth had a high sense of the value of poetry. With discovery of Aristotle Poetics in Italy, there was much critical discussion on poetry. The hostility of the Puritans posed a challenge to the status and value of poetry, and the result was replies and counter replies. Lastly, the best of the Puritan attack is represented by Stephen Garson's School of Abuse. Stephen Garson's School of Abuse. And the best of the replies is Philip Sidney's Apology for Poetry. So these two are very important work. The question will set on these two works. Stephen Garson's School of Abuse and Philip reply to that, Philip Sidney's An Apology for Poetry. Now we discuss what is written or what that the book An Apology for Poetry contains. It is a critical treatise by Philip Sidney, published in 1595 in two separate editions. One is The Defense of Poesy, means The Defense of Poetry. The work achieves the principal aim of the verbal act, persuasion, by painstaking observing the compositional rules of classical oratory. Stephen Garson published The School of Abuse in 1578 after the publication of Sidney's Defense of Poetry 2 years after. Sorry, 3 years after the publication of Philip Sidney's Defense of Poetry, dedicating to it to Sidney apparently without permission. However, it is not clear whether Sidney was replying to the writer, his manner of writing, or the argument. Garson felt that the whole of ancient poetry is infected with the blasphemy and immorality. See, blasphemy and immorality of paganism. So this is the attack of Stephen Gosson on the poetry of Sidney and other contemporaries. He attacked the lies and the license of the poets and playwrights. Stephen Gosson strongly or flatly censured the poetry of Sidney and the drama of his contemporaries. He attacked the lies and the license of the poets and playwrights. An apology is an assessment of the poetic concepts, notions, and standards then availability to the Elizabethan scholars. With an ease of manner and elegance of style, Sidney answers the Puritan objections to imaginative literature in a series of arguments drawn largely from the Italian humanist critics. The apology epitomizes Sidney's sensitivity to contemporary intellectual milieu. Milieu means background, and its critical inheritance. Next point, the apology has 5 divisions. They are exordium, first one exordium, second one narration, the third one preposition, fourth one division, and the last and the fifth one is confirmation. So these are the 5 different divisions of the work apology for poetry or apology for poesy. Major critical precepts of that apology for poetry. See, the universality and the antiquity of poetry. Poets are fathers of learning. So they are respected for their antiquity. Philosophers and historians have appeared in the beginning under the mask of poets. Poetry is universal and it softens hard hearts. Sidney said that poetry is an art of imagination. See, according to Sidney, poetry is an art of imagination. It is a speaking picture. Poetry is a speaking picture, and its aim is to teach and to delight. According to Philip Sidney, the aim of poetry is to teach and delight. This is the main important aim. Sidney divided the poetry into 3 kinds as religious, philosophical, and true kind of poetry. Poetry is superior to both philosophy and history. Once again, I repeat, poetry is superior to both philosophy and history. Philosophy represents merely abstract precepts. Philosophy presents merely abstract precepts which cannot be understood by the young ones. So it is impossible to understand the precepts of philosophy, concepts of philosophy for the young ones. History deals with concrete facts or examples of virtue, but from these facts, the readers must themselves derive universal truths. But poetry combines both these advantages and represents the universal truth. Sidney said that rhyme is not the essential part of poetry. We have to be careful about this. Sidney said, what that Sidney said? Sidney said that Rhyme is not the essential part of poetry, but it is desirable to use because it is a polish to speech. According to Sydney, rhyme is just a polish to speech, but rhyme is not essential part of poetry. It regulates verbal harmony. It adds sensuousness and emotional quality of music to words. Music to words. Once again, repeat. It adds sensuousness and emotional quality of music to words. Charges against poetry and Sydney's answer to them. What that Stephen Garson charged about the poetry of Philip Sidney in his book, The School of Abuse, and what replies did Philip Sidney give to School of Abuse in his defense of poetry? So that is what we have to see here, some points. Poetry is useless and is a waste of time. Here, that Stephen Garson said that poetry is useless and is a waste of time, according to Stephen Garson. See, Sidney replies to him. Sidney replies that poetry is conducive to virtue action. Next point, poetry is the mother of lies. According to Stephen Garson, poetry is the mother of lies. Sidney's reply was that the poet nothing affirms and therefore he never lit. For the lie is to affirm what is not true. Next point, poetry has wanton or corruption influence. It is infected with the theme of love and so fills the mind of men with pestilent desires. Sidney concedes that in much of modern poetry, there is a vicious treatment of love. Love itself is not bad, but it shows an appreciation of beauty. The fault is not with poetry, but with the contemporary abuse of poetry. So friends, if you like this information is useful, if you think this information is useful for preparing that your preparation for the LET and SET, please subscribe to my channel and say some of your suggestions for collecting more information, improvement of the quality of these videos. Thank you friends for watching this video.